Coming up next, the stars come out for People Now with Bill Tush. Right after, follow another exciting case with Perry Mason. Then it's a pregame look at the Atlanta Braves with the on-deck circle, followed by America's team in action against the Chicago Cubs, here on Superstation WTBS. From Hollywood, it's People Now with Bill Tush. Now, here's Bill.
Boy, are we getting swanky, huh? Hey, our guests today, Gloria Loring from The Days of Our Lives, Nikki and David Goldberg, authors of American Whole Foods Cuisine. The Maytag repairman himself, Jesse White, will take to the stage soon in Little Shop of Horrors. We're going to talk about that. Marianne Cravat, the 1983 Playboy Playmate of the Year, is here. But our first guest is on videotape because, I'll explain it to you. You know how we got everybody with health things going around, and of course the aerobics. We've got hundreds of albums. This is called Heavy Hands. Pump It Up is the name of this one. That's one. We've got this one, The Aerobic Dancing for the Family by the ever-popular Judy Scott is one thing there. And here's another one. This is the classic aerobic woman. There she is. Also, on the back of this, it tells you she'll show you the natural way to healthier hair. And here's aerobics dance hits, complete with the hits of Cool and the Gang, Celebration Jungle Boogie, and Hollywood Swinging. And last, but certainly least, is this guy, Richard Simmons, who has his thing called Reach. He's worth $50 million. He wouldn't even send us the album. We just get a picture of that thing there. Anyway. But here in Hollywood, you don't have to just sit home and play records, and you don't have to go out to a health spa. You can actually have it come to you, because here, the health spa is on wheels. It's become America's obsession. Richard Simmons Anatomy Asylum. Holiday Health Spas. Jack LaLanne's European Health Spas. Jane Fonda's Workout. The Sports Connection. There's the endless stream of best-selling books. And, of course, the record albums. Richard Simmons says, reach. Jane Kennedy tells us to love our body. Mousercise from Disney. Linda Fradiani wants us to dance and exercise with the hits. The Jane Fonda workout record. Linda Fradiani Part 2. Olivia on video. Now, just when you thought Americans had gotten the art of perspiring down to a safe science comes, now or never, a workout on wheels. The brainchild of Hans Boehringer, an Australian singer-composer turned kinesiologist, and actress Anne Turkell.
Well, now and never is the name I used to work out Anne, because I want to get her in perfect condition. So one day she didn't want to work out, so I told her, listen, you either do it now or you never do it. That's how the name came about. And the truck itself was, when I was working on my book, Now and Never, Keto Fitness, I decided, you know, I was so pointed down on the book every day in intensive reading and research that I had no time of going to the gym. So I said, it would be great if a truck pulls up with all the equipment and I could work out.
Do you have a lot of customers for this already?
We have about 48 clients and 4 trucks.
And exactly what is on the truck?
We have free weights, fixed weights, muscle toxic testings, food toxic testings, and cardiovascular aerobics.
Why didn't you just open up a health spa somewhere?
Because we have a lot of celebrities. They do not want to be bothered going to a health spa because it's a driving problem, parking problem. So they feel it's much more easier if they just open the door, step out in the truck, and work out.
I think health spas are great for aerobics classes and that sort of thing. But I really wanted to learn about weight training. And the advantage of this is that you're sort of on a one-to-one program. And they specifically design a program for you. And at a health club, a lot of times you have to wait in line for machines and that sort of thing. And you don't really get the individual attention that you get with this. And it's a lot more convenient.
What is the cost of this program?
The cost is $50 an hour for 12 sessions. And the truck itself has equipment worth of $15,000. The whole car is worth about $35,000. and we have everything. We cover from dumbbells, as I said, all the way to electronic muscle stimulants. We have everything in the truck.
I asked a little bit earlier if they have any clients that hide out when the truck pulls up. Are there some mornings when you see this truck coming in the driveway and you just don't want to get in it?
No, Eli's fun, and I'm usually waiting for him.
Where else but in Hollywood?
In Japan, the foot can split
wood,
but it can't split a watermelon. Introducing Ginsu 2, a brand new set of knives, like this Ginsu chef's knife. It's the first one in the world with a dual edge. This special Ginsu serration will cut through a branch and still remain razor sharp. This edge will dice onions so fast there isn't time to cry. Both edges together are like two knives in one. But wait, you also get this matching Ginsu cleaver. It can split a log and still handle your most delicate chopping. This oriental cleaver chops scallions, chops celery, and more. And look, it's specially designed to be a meat tenderizer. How's that for a clever cleaver? Well, we'll even give you this fantastic Ginsu slicing knife with a perpetual edge. The more you use it, the better it cuts. Look at this. You'll go through lettuce quicker than a rabbit. And did you ever slice ham this easily? What are three Ginsu knives like this worth? Don't answer, because you also get a pair of paring knives. You'll always have one handy. Plus, you get this fruit and vegetable knife. It sections grapefruit and cuts cheese. It's so tough, it'll even cut a nail and still go through pineapple like this. Now how much would you pay? Well, you also get this utility knife that cuts tile, cuts eggs, and look what it does for pizza. All these knives come with the famous Ginsu handle. But hold on, you even get six world-famous Ginsu steak knives. They can cut through a tin can and still remain razor sharp. You get 13 fantastic Ginsus, plus our world-famous 50-year guarantee, all for the amazing low price of only $19.99. Here's how to order.
You get 13 fantastic Ginsu knives. Call toll-free 1-800-257-1234 or send $19.99 to Ginsu, Box 7500 Atlanta. That's Ginsu, Box 7500 Atlanta. You get all 13 genuine Ginsu knives, guaranteed in writing for 50 years. Order now.
Well, we're caught in the middle of a love triangle. It seems that our next guest, who plays Liz Courtney on Days of Our Lives, has shot her ex-lover's wife. And everybody wants to know if Marie, who is her ex-lover's wife's name, is going to pull through or possibly go to a soap opera heaven. Here's Gloria Loring. Gloria, of course, is Liz on Days of Our Lives. It does get complicated there, doesn't it?
It gets very bizarre. It gets to the point where you especially when you work many days over and over, that you never get away from the script. And you come home depressed because you've been crying all day about shooting Marie. Your husband says, what's the matter? Oh, never mind. You don't want to know.
Well, you don't really get that involved in it, do you?
Well, you wind up playing those emotions all day, and it's very tiring, and, yeah. And you think about that so much.
Do you do the show 5 days a week?
The last month and a half, I've been doing almost 5 days a week, yeah.
Is Marie going to make it?
I think so. I must tell you, I don't ask in advance. I assume she is. Her contract isn't up for grabs, so at the moment she's a contractable fish.
Well, was the shooting in the show accidental?
Yes. It was an act. What they have tried to do is create a situation where everyone is sort of the victim and no one is really the villain, because basically they took three likable people and just put them in a bizarre set of circumstances. I mean, that's oops. Missed again, you know. Oh, I just was going to come and tell you that you're the father of the baby and you went and eloped with Marie and oops, you know, it was all those oops. It was one oops after another.
Do you ever get into a plot on the show you look at and you think, nobody's going to believe this. This is too crazy.
Yeah, I do that weekly.
Mm-hmm.
What's the matter? My microphone fell off. Oh, dear.
We had the wrong one on. A minor technical problem.
It's live television.
Hey, what are you going to do?
That's all right.
Okay. I guess we got, did we get half of it anyway?
Yeah. Did we get some?
It sounded like we're in an echo.
Loudly.
That was very good.
A lot of gusto.
There you go.
And where were we?
We were into a plot that maybe you wouldn't believe.
A lot of them I haven't believed, and I've had to play them. I didn't believe it emotionally, and it gets difficult.
Yeah. How long have you been with the show?
I've been with the show 3 years now.
Really?
Yeah, it's gone very quickly.
Now, when you had the singing career before, which you still have,
yes.
You still do that. You do that on the show also, don't you?
Yes, Liz sings also, and I'm, yeah. I do concerts. I was out recently with Bill Cosby, but mostly I do one or two nights. So I can't get away for very long because we're in production 52 weeks a year.
Yeah. Did you want to get into an acting career when you did the...
Yeah, I always had that in the back of my mind. I studied off and on for 10 years from the time I was a teenager when I first started on the Merv Griffin Show and started singing. And it was one of the things everybody would say, oh, well, you're a very nice singer, dear, but if we have a part for a singer, we'll call you, but you're not an actress. And
yeah.
They wouldn't even let me read. They said, oh, well, you're a singer. But, no, but I'm an actress. No, but you're a singer. It's like you can't do two things. And I said, wait a minute, Diana Ross and Barbara Streisand, you know, da-da-da-da-da, you know, please. And then I finally got a chance, and it's been wonderful. I do remember, though, when I finally, you know, after having a lot of bravado about, well, I'm an actress, and then getting on the show on my first day at work, I was petrified. I couldn't think, I couldn't see, I couldn't breathe, I couldn't speak.
Was that your first acting role?
That was really my first acting job. And I figured, that's it, they're going to find me out, they're going to fire me. They're going to figure out I don't know what in the world I am doing. And somehow I got through it that first day, and then little by little I gained confidence that, maybe I can do what I've been saying. But I've grown and learned so much during that time.
Yeah.
What we do, I mean, you know, doing 30, 40 pages a day is like an advanced kind of rep company. And you're really on the line. It's like doing live television, only with a little safety built in.
Mm-hmm. I know. Whenever we get somebody on here with soap opera, they always talk about the fact you got to learn so many lines.
Get to a point where I did last week, where I just started crying on the set, and I said, nothing more will go in. I can't do this.
You do a lot of crying on the set.
For one reason or another.
You also have written a couple of the songs that we hear a lot.
Yes.
The two TV shows, Different Strokes.
My husband and I wrote the theme for Different Strokes and The Facts of Life, yeah. And I sing the Facts of Life theme.
Oh, you do that?
Yes, that's me singing.
That's nice.
You take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and there you have. Thank you.
We always sneak some entertainment
here somewhere. Energy for the end of the day, I can't believe it.
You just got done shooting today?
Yes, yeah. Mm. Mm.
But you're up, excited.
I know, I think it's. I've been hyperventilating a lot.
You gotta tell us about your husband's new show, Alan Thicke.
Yes,
Everybody's
talking about it. I'm real excited about it. He's had the most successful talk show in the history of Canadian television for the last 3 years. And now he and Fred Silverman and MGM and Metro Media have put together a whole package, and they've got 100 stations right now, which is 75% of the markets. And they're going on, and the interesting thing is they've gone sort of across the board. They're on independents, they're on ABC, NBC, and CBS affiliates. They've sort of cut right across. And it starts in September.
Oh, it is? It comes
on
September?
Thick of the Night.
Yeah.
And
what's it going to be?
What's it going to be? Good question. Well, my husband produced and helped create Fernwood Tonight and America Tonight for Norman Lear. So he will not take the talk show format very seriously. It will be researched and scripted much more than it will be off the cuff, just talk.
Yeah.
He has some wonderful ideas, and I don't want to give too much away, but most of all, I think he sees himself as the glue between all of the elements, as opposed to a stand-up comedian or a singer or a dancer or anything else. He's sort of the middleman. He's the middle America. He's in the middle of it and makes it all work. He's in the thick of it.
The thick of it. And the thing that a lot of people are talking about that got a lot of press is the fact that a lot of the... in fact, Johnny Carson owned stations.
He owned two stations that have picked up Alan's show, and also one of the NBC affiliates in Baltimore has dropped Carson's show and is going to pick up Alan's show. Which was big news, yeah. It'll be. Well, the pressure's on now. You know, okay, great. So you've had success, but you better be funny, kid.
That's it. So you'll know in September.
Yes.
Really.
I know. Well, it's a big move. And
when he did the show in Canada, it was daily.
Yes.
And
yes.
You were doing the show here.
Yes. That was difficult. We waved a lot at airports, you know. It was difficult. He would tape between July and December and was gone two-thirds of the time. And when I was home on the weekends, he was away. So somehow we got through it, though.
And that lasted for how many years? Three years?
3 years,
for
yeah.
3 years?
Yeah. That's so terrific. Now he's here, so it's like, you're home, you know.
And you still managed to raise two kids.
Yes, yes.
While all that was going on.
Yes, they're doing all right. They're 6 and 8, two boys. Yeah. And my once older son, Brennan, has diabetes, and one of the things we had talked about was the fact that I did this Days of Our Lives cookbook, which your network has been very good about helping me promote, and mm-hmm. I'd like to let the people out there know that we, the Days of Our Lives Celebrity Cookbook has shipped over 55,000 books and raised over $350,000 for diabetes research.
Great.
And we're doing another one, and this September there'll be a volume 2. With all the new people who've joined the cast in the last year and a half.
Was it they put their favorite recipes?
Yep, everybody's favorite recipe and an autograph and a photo and little personal comments about themselves and their life and their home or their upbringing. And
we'll give it a plug. How do you get it?
Sure, you send a minimum $10 donation to the Juvenile Diabetes Foundation, to Cookbook, care of NBC in Burbank, California.
Okay. Great.
It's easy enough.
Hope we sold a few for it.
I know. Well, we did last time. It's done very well.
Great.
It really has.
Okay, Gloria. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Nice seeing you.
Next time we'll get the right microphone on the first time.
Yeah. Well, hey, you project very well.
All right.
We're going to be back with Officer Byrd of the Los Angeles Police Department.
Introducing new sugar-free Kool-Aid.
Now kids, have a sugar-free from Kool-Aid.
Gotta be
right. One sugar-free for kids.
It's about time they made a sugar-free for kids. Pre-sweetened with NutraSweet, a new natural-tasting sweetener for that great Kool-Aid taste.
It's the one sugar-free
Kool-Aid
for kids.
About half the price of soda with vitamin C. Kool-Aid makes the only sugar-free for my kids.
It's the one sugar-free, sugar-free for kids.
Kool-Aid brand sugar-free soft drink mix.
Patty, you didn't finish your cereal. Don't you like the taste?
It lost its crunch.
What can I do?
Try deliciously crunchy Post Honey Nut Crunch Raisin Bran. Starts crunchy and stays crunchy with golden honey, chopped walnuts, crunchy cereal nuggets, and the goodness of Post Raisin Bran.
You finished.
It's a crunchy.
Oh. Try Post Honey Nut Crunch Raisin Bran. Delicious goodness that starts crunchy
and stays crunchy. I'm no Admiral refrigerator to make ice cream. I made strawberry.
I made a blueberry yogurt freeze.
I made paradise punch.
I made vesves.
Admiral just invented the world's first refrigerators that make ice cream.
Amazing, but it's true. It's super ice cream lovers from Admiral.
This is the city. There are over 6 million birds in this city, and one of them is Officer Byrd. Bum, ba-dum, bum. Bum, ba-dum, bum. And there he is. This guy is a real live member of the Los Angeles Police Department. He is Officer Byrd, because he's a bird, and he is owned and operated by Officer Mike, who is a real live L.A. policeman. And he's a big part of the Los Angeles Police Department.
Yes, he is.
What exactly does he do? I mean, to tell everybody about LAPD.
Well, Officer Byrd and I go around to schools and we teach safety. The Byrd does various stunts to get the kids' attention, and that's the reason we started, because when we went to schools before, we noticed a short attention span of children. So I was at Busch Gardens watching birds perform, and that's where I came up with the idea. So I brought the Byrd from a guy named Jack Kelly, who helped me train Officer Byrd, and then I started doing these shows about 5 years ago.
He's on TV a lot out here also.
Well, he has his own commercials. Mm-hmm. On, matter of fact, they're shown on almost every channel. He's been seen on many, many national talk shows. And he's a real member of police.
I love his outfit. Can we get it? Look at his outfit. He's got his own badge.
He doesn't really wear this now.
His number is 007.
That's good.
He's not trained to kill, he's trained to poop. And he does have his own ID card. Mm-hmm. And he is the national safety mascot for Cub Scouts of America. And then Mark Fungu made him the California State Safety Mascot, and the Mayor Bradley made him the city safety mascot. So he gets around, and
he gets around in his own police car.
Police car, that's right.
We got his own. I love this police car.
There we go. Huh? He's known as One Atom Bird. That's what I tell kids. You know, we talk about police officers. Our job is to help people. And he's known as One Atom Bird, so he'll get a call, One Atom Bird, One Atom Bird, Burn Avenue, Progress Code 3. And he's trained like other policemen to go to the rescue right away. So, you watch. He goes right to the rescue right away.
Right to the
there
police.
There he goes. Right into the, no, goes. No, don't check under the hood. Everything's okay under there. He already stopped the windshield and then you're done. Yes.
I'll be darned.
There we go. And then he goes right to the rescue. Let's go to the rescue. And there he goes. All the way. Good for you, Officer Bird.
Oh, there he's paid. He gets paid off.
And then we go into skateboard safety. And, you know, we tell children to wear knee pads and elbow pads and wrist guards and watch out for people walking on sidewalks, things like that. And we have a little scooter skateboard that we use right here.
Is he a regular parrot, is he? What is he?
He's a macaw, blue and gold macaw. He comes from Brazil, which is, you know, of course, South America.
This is a real honor for me because I work with Alfie Cockatoo, Zippy the Chimp, Rex the Underdog, all the
there he goes. Good for you. We teach a lot about also stay away from strangers, things like that, we tell the kids. And we reach kids from kindergarten to sixth grade. He's also going to have an Officer Bird Safety Club, which is coming up soon in a few weeks, where kids can write to us, and they'll get a safety patch, autographed picture from Officer Bird, a welcome letter, newsletters, and all kinds of nifty things. He also throws away trash. He has a little trash can here, you know, trash and safety.
A good thing to learn.
Little 7-Up bottle. You know, when he's visiting the Beverly Hills Police Department?
Sure.
They serve Perrier.
Oh, he's a little Perrier.
These are my small jokes. And then, of course, he throws away trash. Put it right in there. There you go.
What kind of schedule does he keep? Or I should say the both you keep.
Well, we do presentations almost every day. Weekends are filled with a lot of charities. Matter of fact, we're going to be going up to Berkeley to do the Special Olympics. We do travel through California to do safety shows and different things on TV.
Have any other cities around the country contacted you about maybe setting up their own program?
Hawaii. They sent a guy from Hawaii who came out to see a show, and I told him how to train a bird. He has a blue and gold he's going to use. From Vernon PD came out. A person from New York gave me a call, wants to start something, and a Canadian Mountie called me and wants to start something up there. So, he's getting around, and it really works. He saves money. Yeah, has a little piggy bank right here.
His own bank?
Yeah, a little bank.
He has his own office.
He has his own office, actually.
City Hall East,
that's right. A little quarter, I guess. Not too much money.
Okay.
Doesn't trust me, though. Doesn't trust me. He always takes a peek, you see, after it's done, you see, so doesn't make a lot of money. He even plays basketball. That's right.
And how long did it take you to teach him?
Well, Jack and I worked with Officer Bird for about 8 months before we did our first show. All these stunts that you're seeing today took over 3 years to actually teach them to do all of them. This basketball, for instance, took actually only 2 hours. Not very long at all.
Smart bird. Are they all that smart?
No, not at all. They're all like people sometimes, you know, different personalities. You put the ball down there, he picks it up, brings it over to the little basketball hoop here. You know,
he does it with his claw.
Oh, sure.
Right there.
With his little claw. There you go. Let it go. Good for you, Officer.
Does he ever get tired and not want to work?
One time, and it was on Cinco de Mayo Day, and I went to a restaurant.
Last week, I fed him.
It was a year before. Oh. I fed him tortilla chips, and of course, when he gets real full, like all of us, he doesn't like to work too much. And we went to a show, and he just kind of looked at me and says, "Hey, you know, this is my holiday," so he decided not to work.
You better get him a double.
We do have another bird that I'm training right now.
How old is he?
He's 8 years old.
8 years old? What is their life expectancy?
About 80 to 150.
Oh,
I have a good job.
You'll be retired.
Yeah.
You and that bird will be sitting somewhere in a...
You know when he plays basketball, you know what his nickname is? Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Small jokes. But anyway, let's get to bike safety here. He rides a bicycle. And of course, we talk about bike safety.
Mm-hmm.
Bird really works. He's a star. Star.
It's a neat little bike.
Here we go, all the way. Here we go.
Look at that.
$400. That bike right there was made by a man named Hubert Manning. That's who made the props.
Jeez. That is a handmade bicycle.
Yes.
You bought it like a Bird World or something.
And he also roller skates. Actually, roller skates. This is probably one of the most difficult stunts you can teach a bird. It has nothing to hold on to on these. And there you go. Come on, all the way now. There we go.
Jeez.
Come on. This took about 5.5 months. This was a very long stunt. Good for you, Officer Bird.
Officer Bird.
Great bird. We also talk about fire prevention, about you know, if your clothes are ever on fire, to stop, drop, and roll over. Well, Officer Bird was taught to do a rollover. Very unusual to see a bird do that because they don't like to go on their back at all. And if you just stand back a little there, I'll have them do a rollover. Let me get them in the middle.
Okay.
You want to roll over? Roll over, roll over, roll over. Come on, all the way. There you go. Good for you, Officer Bird.
Now, that looks like a tricky trick, if that's the right way to put it.
Tricky trick?
A tricky trick for him to learn.
Yeah, that took a year. Like that took over a year. Another one that I've been working on is it's kind of a lullaby, you know, teach kids to, you know, to kind of get over nice and easy. And what I do is I pick them up. Now, birds don't like to be picked up too much. And carry my arms like this, and I can actually, you know, just swing them back and forth. That's how much trust he has.
Jeez, for me. Like you said, they won't normally do that, will they?
Not too much. You know, let you really work with them a lot.
That's super.
And he knows how to kiss. You want to give him a kiss? And don't worry.
You won't get
chirpies either, okay? Just want you to know. And if you do, it's tweetable. So, right? Just, there you go.
You don't tell that joke in schools.
No. I don't tell that joke in schools. No.
Okay. Well, Officer Mike, thank you. And Officer Bird, we'll see you again.
You want to wave goodbye? Wave goodbye to everybody.
Bye.
There you go. You want to say bye? Say bye. Say bye.
Ah!
There you go.
The Maytag repairman, Jesse White, when we come back. Stay with us.
A diamond is the world's hardest substance, but 2 years later, you still can't cook on it. Introducing Armor Coat 2. It's brand new, with bigger and better pieces like this huge non-stick 3-quart saucepan. Watch. These are burnt baked beans. A disaster. But with Armor Coat 2, they come out this quick. This incredible saucepan comes with a cover that also fits our amazing cook and serve pan. It, too, has the famous Armor Coat surface. Even burnt pudding won't stick to it. And look, the pans go together to form a double boiler. It's great for sauces, melting chocolate, and steaming vegetables. Next, we'll baby you with the world's greatest baby food warmer and non-stick egg poacher. How much would you pay for a 7-in-1 combination like this? Don't answer until you see this extra deep covered fryer. It holds more chicken than a hen house. Does scrambled egg mess leave you shell-shocked? How's that for nonstick? And you can even make pancakes without a spatula. But wait, there's still more to Armor Coat 2, because this cover fits a gigantic 5-quart Dutch oven. Cook a huge pot roast, make mounds of spaghetti, a gallon of chili, and heaps of boiled potatoes. And if they burn, don't worry, this is Armor Coat 2. Now how much would you pay? Well, hold on to your seat, because you also get a complete Armor Coat bakeware set at no extra cost. Muffins flip out like this. Cakes come out like this. And bread pops out like this. It's also great for meatloaf. You get all this fabulous Armor Coat cookware and bakeware for the incredible low price of only $34.99. We challenge you to find a better value anywhere.
COD and credit card customers call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. To save COD charges, use your credit card or send $34.99 to Cook and Bake, Box 7500 Atlanta. You get the amazing 7-in-1 combination, the extra deep fryer, the huge Dutch oven, plus the complete bakeware set. Limit 2 per customer. Order now.
Aren't we nice? And we give the CBS plays down the street a plug. That's real great. Our most beloved Maytag repairman is with us.
The loneliest man
the lonely. In town. Right now he's appearing on stage in the Little Shop of Horrors. Jesse White.
Thank you.
Join him and Bill, enjoyed him.
Bill Tushy. That's such a cute name.
Tush.
Tush.
I have enough trouble with
it. Bill that. Tush. Oh, I thought it was Tush.
You just told me how many years of Maytag?
17.
17 years?
17 years of the most lovely years of my life. And I'd like to go another 17.
Sure. Why not?
But in the meantime, it allows me, thank God, it allows me to do a play occasionally, and I just want to say this before we go any further, that I am appearing in one of the most unusual, delightfully funny shows that's ever played in Los Angeles, and a show that is not dirty. You can bring the whole family, and they'll have one of the greatest, happiest evenings they ever spent in the theater.
That's great. Where is it?
Westwood Playhouse. We play Tuesday through Sunday. We have a matinee on Sunday afternoon at 2:30, and we play two shows Saturday night. And if you really want to have some, have you seen it yet?
No, I haven't.
You're in for a treat.
That was a Roger Corman film, wasn't it?
He's been getting more publicity than anybody. You know that picture that he made for $16, and he shot it in like 2 days.
It was one of those,
yeah,
real low budget.
One of those Roger Corman spectaculars.
And you play Mr. Mushnick.
Mushnick.
Or as I would say,
yeah,
Mr.
the director.
Mushnick.
See what it says on it?
Oh, you've got a race. Oh, that's great.
The director gave us a little bracelet. Present. Yeah, it's such a joy to go out on stage, and it's. The audiences just love it. Just love it.
What is it about?
It's about a botanical phenomenon. That's all I'm going to tell you. I don't want to give it away.
You have to see it.
Because there's an element of surprise in it. And just come and see it. And if you can get a ticket.
It's doing that well.
Yeah. The show is a runaway hit. And Los Angeles really needed one.
Yeah, they always say L.A. is not a theater town.
Well, those who say it are eating their words, because it is. I think eventually they're decentralizing the theater in New York and Broadway because of the prohibitive costs of doing a show in New York. So now L.A., the next in line is Los Angeles. Mm. And it's becoming. Look at all the shows that are playing here.
Yeah.
And this show, they expect it to run for a year.
Great.
Yep.
So you don't mind doing it that long?
No. I don't know how long I can be with it. They allow me to do if Maytag, naturally, is I can't jeopardize my Maytag position. So I have an understudy that plays it if I have to go somewhere for Maytag for a couple of days.
You do other things besides the commercials. I guess you make appearances.
Yeah, I do nightclubs, and I do one-nighters, and I do other commercials. They allow me to do other commercials.
Yeah, and I guess the TV, different TV shows you still
do. Yeah, you do Heart to Heart and Trapper John and all those marvelous shows.
You know, you're one of the guys, because of your talent, you're always working. Always got something
going
on.
They ever get wise to me, I'll be back selling shoes.
Is that where it started?
Yeah.
Really?
Tom McCann's shoes.
Where?
30 cents an hour, Akron, Ohio.
Is that your home?
Yeah.
Oh.
Left at an early age, as soon as I found out where I was. And they built a friend. Is she on a death watch over here? What is she doing?
She watches the time.
Oh.
Yeah, because we know you got a curtain call, so we don't want you to miss it.
But you got to come and see us.
Oh, I will, for sure.
The other night, Vincent Minnelli was in, and Jimmy Stewart and his wife were in, and they just...
Well, there's an old buddy of yours, Jimmy Stewart.
Jimmy Stewart. We're talking about doing Harvey again.
Really?
Yeah.
Like played the male nurse in Harvey.
Yeah. I've played that over 2,200 times.
Boy, you talk about a long run.
4 years on Broadway.
Was it really?
And the movie and the one television version.
What version was it on television?
That was the David Susskind version, of which there's still a reward out for. What they did to that.
Really?
They try to improve it, you see. Once in a while I've done it with directors who try to improve Harvey. And you just don't improve it. You play it the way it's written.
Yeah. How tall was Harvey?
6'3".
6'3".
Yeah.
And Jimmy Stewart never gets tired of doing that either.
No. We're talking about doing it here. I'd like to open it here at the Huntington Hartford, and he'd like to take it to Australia.
Is it ever, I guess it's played there before.
No. Oh, it's played there, but it's been so long, but not with a superstar like Jimmy. He loves that place.
Oh, that'd be great to see him in that. See both of you in that.
Yeah. I keep doing it till I get it right.
Do you ever turn on TV, see yourself in something you forgot you did? I saw you on a Twilight Zone episode with Carol Burnett. Sure.
That was supposed to be a series that Rod Serling wrote for me, God rest his soul.
You were an angel.
An angel, third class, yeah. And it was just chemistry was wrong with the people connected with it.
Oh, because the one episode you did was great.
But they keep playing it. I did about 6 or 7 Twilight Zones.
Oh, you did that many?
Yeah. And my past keeps catching up with me, but I love it. I would love to see myself and see how I've aged gracefully.
Oh, you have. Well, I've always wanted to meet you. I'm glad I got the opportunity.
Hey, thank you. And
well,
you're
going to see
you promise you're going to come over and see the show?
Promise.
Westwood Playhouse, Westwood, LeConte Avenue.
Okay, that's a nice theater, too.
Matinees, Sundays. And bring the kids. They'll have a ball.
Okay, thank you, Jesse.
Thank you.
It was fun meeting you. Thanks for being with us. We're going to be back with the authors of the American Whole Foods Cuisine.
If you have pigmentation brown spots like these...
I hate them.
This is Porcelana Fade Cream.
I used a fade cream for a while, but I stopped using it because I really didn't think it was working. Then my sister told me, Helen, get Porcelana and keep using it. It does work.
Porcelana works gradually, but it does work.
My spots are much less noticeable now. Porcelana does work if you stick with it.
Porcelana, and now Porcelana with sunscreen, to help keep the sun from darkening the brown spots Porcelana's trying to lighten.
Beautiful, Miss Morrow. I wish someone would send me flowers.
Special delivery. Introducing the newest Beautiful Ones bra with a corsage design from Playtex Cross Your Heart.
Sleek and lacy, corsage applique, even the package is beautiful.
I recommend you wear the bra, and it lifts and separates for a better figure.
Better figure? I'll buy that.
Cash or charge? Try Playtex Cross Your Heart's new Beautiful Ones bra. Special introductory price $9.99.
Every weeknight, go beyond the news with Freeman Reports. Sandy Freeman goes to the source to get the answers you need. Plus, a phone call can put you in touch with today's newsmakers. Weeknights at 10 Eastern, go beyond the news to meet the people making the news. Get your answers on Freeman Reports.
Catch those hard-hitting Atlanta Braves in action when they take on the Chicago Cubs today, 2:05 Eastern on Superstation WTBS.
To the pros, it's more than a game. It's a way of life.
Don't get down. You've been swinging a bad good all spring.
Tonight at 8:05, join us for a special encore presentation of It's a Long Way to October, inside the 1982 Braves.
There's only one place to finish, and that's first.
It's a fascinating look at the Atlanta Braves. Join us for It's a Long Way to October, a two-part special beginning tonight at 8:05 on Superstation WTBS.
All right, raw vegetables, tofu, bean sprouts, wheat cakes. Might not sound appetizing, but as our next guest will tell us, eating high fiber, low salt, low fat, and low sugar diets can be quite tasty. Here's our authors, Nikki and David Goldbeck, and here's their book, which has 1,300 meatless, wholesome recipes from short order to gourmet, as the cover says. And this is all meatless, 1,300 recipes. How'd you find 1,300 recipes?
Well, actually, we found 2,000 and cut it down to 1,300. We've been eating in the natural foods mode for almost 10 years now. And that book is a result of the research and the eating around the world and different restaurants that it's been our great pleasure to do.
Are you advocating vegetarianism?
No, we're not advocating vegetarianism for the majority of the public, but what we are advocating is the use of more vegetarian-type food in the American diet, which most Americans know they need. But most of us know that we're eating too much fat, there's not enough fiber in the diet, there's too much sugar and salt. And whole foods cuisine goes beyond just vegetarianism, beyond just health foods, to try to give people food that tastes good and happens to be healthy.
Mm-hmm. Now, is that whole food, is that, what, natural food?
Well, it has been known as natural food, but I think that's a misleading term. I mean, you can consider almost anything natural. What we consider whole foods are foods that are only minimally processed or unprocessed and are those foods that our ancestors ate traditionally, beans, grains, nuts, seeds, dairy products. We're not even excluding meat from the definition of whole foods. But we're excluding those foods which are chemically processed, which are artificially colored, flavored, highly refined. And it's really a very basic diet. It's nothing radical. It's nothing, I mean, you start out with sprouts and wheat cakes. That's really a very minimal part of what whole foods are all about.
How come, why is it that whole foods and natural foods are always more expensive than the other stuff?
Well, that's a question that everybody asks, and the main reason is because the demand is limited. When you go into a health food store, you go into a specialized store which is smaller traffic, they buy from a smaller wholesaler, and until there's a greater demand for these foods, we will pay a premium, but you're also paying a premium for better food. So it's not like you're getting, something, you're not getting what you're paying for. You can get ripped off in a supermarket, you can get ripped off in a health food store, but you are paying a premium for a specialized market.
Well, chemicals are cheaper than food, and that's one of the problems. If you want to eat ersatz food, it's much easier to produce something in a laboratory than it is to grow it in the fields.
Ersatz food?
Ersatz means artificial.
Oh, okay. I thought that was some brand.
She's just showing her age.
Well, like you said, what, 10 years you've been doing this now?
More than 10 years.
Well, what was the thing that you noticed the most, that how your life has changed?
We began to experience a lot more interesting cuisines than we had before. We were really in this meat, potato, salad rut, and all of a sudden we discovered, wow, there's a lot of cuisines out there we've never tried. More of the Italian peasant kind of cuisine, a much broader spectrum of the Asian cuisines, Mexican. There were so many foods that most people bypass that are on many menus, but really when you go out to a restaurant, you look at the top of the menu, the roast beef, the steak, you don't look at the eggplant, you may not look at the pasta dish, the bean dish. So primarily we discovered that eating was a lot more interesting than it was before.
Has your health changed any? Or you feel like you're more
helpful? It's much easier to control your weight, for one thing, because these foods have much less calories, it's much less expensive, and every governmental and scientific authority that has studied the American diet, and there's been a number of them in the last 10 years, has said that the direction that Nikki and I teach nutrition is the direction that we should be going. But what everyone says is that we don't know how to get the American public to do this. Well, Nikki and I think we do. We've been teaching nutrition for 10 years. There's 1.5 million of our books in circulation at this point, and a lot of people seem to think...
1.5 million?
Yes, 1.5 million.
How many books besides this one have you done?
There's four other books.
Four other books.
Yes. And we have a book called The Supermarket Handbook, which tried to show people how to get the best foods from the supermarket, and an American Whole Foods Cuisine, we're trying to show people what they can do with the foods when they get them home. We have an example here, by the way, of the kind of things that we advocate.
Probably everybody watching was saying, gee, going to cook something because there's a bunch of food on their table.
Right.
It's a brand name thing.
Well, we don't talk about
that. Brand names aren't really the consideration. There are many foods in the supermarket that are made just like you would make them at home, so we have nothing against buying prepared foods. We just want them prepared the same way they would be if we were going to prepare them.
This thing's hot. Is this too hot?
I'm burning the skillet here. Well, what I wanted to show your audience is the fact that we've developed a very interesting substitute for bacon that we call cheesin. And all it is fried provolone cheese. And you simply have to take a slice of good quality provolone cheese and put it on a skillet, and this is a pretty hot one at this point, and after a while, it will brown up like this cheese that I've already prepared that's on there.
Before and after.
Right. And if you'd like to taste it, I think you'll find that it's very salty, crisp, and smoky, very much like bacon, and it has lots of advantages.
I don't want to eat too much because we're going out for a pizza.
Right, what do I want?
A 12-pack after.
Pizza's not, it's a pretty nourishing food if it's made
properly.
That's
one of the things, people think of health foods and they think of, as you said, sprouts, but we think of pizza.
How can you get that off of there?
Well, this is Teflon, so it'll come off very easily, but even if it was on another frying pan, once it cools down, it peels right off. You've probably noticed that when you do cooking, the little cheese that runs off. Do you ever cook?
No.
You know, when you go out for pizza.
No, I just moved in by myself out here, and I have a new thing. I go out once a week, I buy food, I take it home, put it in the refrigerator, watch it rot, throw it away, and then go buy some more.
Well, this is your opportunity to use it. We've got 170 short order recipes, so you don't even have to think about it more than 10 minutes before you're ready to eat.
170?
Short order recipes alone, because we know a lot of people don't want to have to plan to... do a meal and cook
now,
for hours.
Where did the recipes come from?
We stole them. We've been collecting recipes, traveling around the world, eating in different restaurants, and using those as inspiration for our cooking. Nikki has a degree in nutrition and is trained in food science, which is rare for cookbook writers. I'm a lawyer and obviously has no relationship at all to the subject.
This is like a sideline?
No, this is a full-time occupation. As I said, Nikki and I have written 5 books. There are 1.5 million books in print. We travel and lecture and write, and we do a lot of work with pregnant women in nutrition, and this is the work we have been doing for the last 10 years.
You change your diet drastically. Suddenly, go by everything in the book here. Mm-hmm. Do you need to see a doctor to get any
Depends on what your health is right
specific
now.
Specific advice? You mean in terms of this diet? No, this diet is the same nutritionally as any diet would be. As a matter of fact, because we don't use any meat, and we know people are often concerned, where is my protein going to come from? We rate all the recipes, explaining how much protein is in them compared to a meat meal. If there's not enough protein, what else you can add to make the protein of equal quality to a meat meal. So there's absolutely no worry in this kind of a diet. We have hundreds and hundreds of menu suggestions because we really want everyone to understand that this is something you don't have to be afraid of. It's a normal way of eating. People all over the world eat this way. Being a vegetarian is not something that's strange or foreign to most people.
When you hear tofu, which sounds like some kind of strange thing from the middle of India somewhere, what is that?
Well, tofu is a cheese made from soybeans, very much like we make cheese from milk, but it has a lot of advantages over milk cheese in that it has no cholesterol and is very, very low in fat. It's also inexpensive, high in protein, but it has the disadvantage of looking strange and having a strange name. We have new techniques in American Whole Foods cuisine for using tofu in after you've frozen it, because it becomes much tougher, much more like chicken and veal. And we have found that that makes it much more acceptable to the American palate. And of course, the important part about that food is it again helps Americans fulfill these dietary goals, these new directions that we're beginning to realize are needed in our diet.
Mm-hmm. Now what about, is it a substitute for meat?
Yes.
Could it be?
In the Orient, they call it the meat of the fields.
Do they really?
Yes.
Where's the most unusual place you found the recipe?
Most unusual in terms of cuisines? Well, I'd say the most unusual cuisine to America right now comes probably from Indonesia, with the food that's just being introduced into the West, which is called tempeh, which is another soy product made with a fermented soybean. And although
like,
it looks rather
like
strange,
cheese.
It's like blue cheese. It's got a mold growing on top of it. Most people go, oh, this is gray, and we don't eat gray food in this country. But the truth is, when it's fried up, it makes one of the best burgers.
The restaurant I go to, I have to ask every time I wonder what color the food is.
Well, I don't know. I'd rather eat gray food with a mold than blue food with food coloring. So it just becomes a matter of what you're used to and where your definitions of food lie. I don't think blue dye is food, so, you know, your definition.
Now, do you ever get off your way of eating?
Well,
maybe just, like, break it once in a while?
Well, yes and no. I mean, there is no on and off. We do what we want to do. And what we want to do is try to eat in a healthier way, mostly because we enjoy that kind of eating. So if we get off it, it's only because we happen to enjoy that food. So if you went out with me after the show, I would sit down with you and have a beer.
Excuse
or
me.
A feather.
Officer Bird lost one of his feathers and wanted it in our sandwich.
I was told never to follow a bird, actually.
Yeah.
We're very liberal in our outlook, and that's what a lot of people like. We'll have dessert with you, we'll have cocktails, but we prefer generally to eat this way because we simply enjoy it more.
Because I know of some people that have gotten, they'll be vegetarians, mm-hmm. and they'll get off of, like maybe once in a while, they'll sneak a burger or something, mm-hmm. and they get bad reactions, they get sick from.
Yeah. Well, we haven't done that, but it's not sneaking a burger, and that's the whole part of eating. I mean, we don't consider this as a masochistic diet or something that's got rules and regulations to it. People should eat what they want to eat. I feel very strongly about that. I don't want someone telling me what to eat and what not to eat. But what our aim is to do is show people what their choices are, that they really have can have a lot more variety in their diet than maybe they have now, that maybe some of the foods that they are unfamiliar with can become a comfortable part of their diet without throwing out everything in their cupboard right now and totally reorienting the way they eat. There is no right or wrong. There's just ways of making the quality of your diet a little bit better, or ways of sometimes eating foods that may not be the best for you, but knowing it and doing it consciously.
Now, don't you have a problem, too, that you always have to go to special stores to buy most things?
Well, that was true up until a few years ago when we did this book called The Supermarket Handbook, in which we identified by brand name hundreds and hundreds of products sold only in supermarkets throughout the United States that met the test of wholeness that we had decided on, one that Nikki mentioned earlier. In other words, unpolluted foods without food additives and unnecessary salt and sugar. We found hundreds and hundreds of those foods, and we didn't believe we could. So you don't have to go to a health food store. You can shop in a supermarket, neighborhood market, farmer's market. You can grow your own food. It just depends on how much money you have and on the quality of food you like to buy for yourself.
Now I want to see you get that off of there. I really want to see this come. Oh, look, it does come right off.
Oh, yeah, it comes right off. Yeah, and you can use it, of course, on a regular skillet, because once cheese cools, it contracts and it peels right off. It's much easier to make on this kind of a skillet. And you also see some of the fat comes off, which makes this cheese less fatty than eating the cheese in its normal state.
Mm-hmm. Now, you can use this just like you use bacon. David will put the sandwich together and give you something to eat. But you could use this on a spinach salad. We know you're
salivating. Well, give it to the bird.
Oh, yeah.
You could use this on a spinach salad, you know,
let's
pancakes
cook Officer
and
Bird.
Bacon.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, we cooked tofu and we found that the dog act loved it too. So.
Oh, really?
That was
on the other show you're on, they had a dog act.
This is just a regular sandwich, and this is one of the things.
We should talk to our agent.
If you like a sandwich, there's nothing wrong with using a whole grain bread, using a good quality cheese, mayonnaise, lettuce, tomato. I mean, this isn't something that's so foreign or weird.
Well, as I said, this is what we call a CLT, which is our American Whole Foods BLT, and you make it the same way as any other BLT, except using tomato. Here we use tomato and some lettuce. And
looks a little brown.
Well, that's the red leaf lettuce.
No, that's red leaf lettuce.
Oh. Like I said, I watch my food rot.
When was the last time you had a meal in the daylight?
I hang on very dark joints.
And as you see, I am just putting the cheese on just like it was bacon and making a sandwich that you will see looks, and even to our meat-eating friends, tastes very much like a BLT.
Okay. What is the name of that cheese? One more time.
Provolone cheese, simply fried in a skillet.
Sold in your neighborhood supermarket.
Okay. I'm not going to sample any now.
Do I do this for a living?
You can have some.
Oh, I've tasted it millions of times. It doesn't prove anything.
Well,
but
yeah, really, you know, I always wonder why people on television shows always do this. Somebody will cook them, and then they taste it. And then they go, oh, boy, that's great.
Well, I'm waiting for the time when they say, that's terrible.
No, this is good, though. I like this. This is good. This is the cheese already cooked.
See, and you can use that in salads or in pancakes.
On pancakes?
Mm-hmm.
You know, cheese bacon and pancakes? Well, that's how you get some protein in your meal. If you eat pancakes with syrup, you've got nothing but carbohydrate.
I better go. I better take this book home and start cooking. Well, thank you for being with us.
Thank you. This is a lot of fun.
Okay, and I'll tell you what, I don't know what our next guest has been eating, but apparently it's worked. She's the 1983 Playboy Playmate of the Year. Stay with us for there.
Award winner Ann Murray, just one of 30 great country music stars in All-Star Country Gold, a new three-record collection featuring country greats like Hank Williams Jr.
All my rowdy friends have settled down.
And Eddie Rabbit.
Step by step, you're with love. You can bet your heart on me.
Johnny Lee.
Honey, you can be a winner.
Eddie Raven and Gary Morris.
Headed for a heartache. Better stop before it's too late.
All-Star Country Gold contains the greatest collection of original hits ever offered.
There's an old flame burning in your eyes.
Alabama.
But I believe in love.
Don Williams.
Ooh, baby.
Barbara Vandrell.
I wish you were here.
She tried to hide it by the faded denim clothes she wore.
Conway Twitty and Mel Tillis.
Blowing from the coast of Mississippi.
Cause anywhere there's a jute bar.
Razzie Bailey.
Or I'd rather be lonely without you.
Dave Rowland and Sugar. All-Star Country Gold is a must for your record collection. Giant three-record set or two 8-track or cassette tapes, only $13.98. Here's how to order.
To order, phones toll-free, 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, call 800-232-6966. To avoid COD charges, send check or money order for $13.98 for records, $13.98 for tapes to All-Star Country Gold, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta. Prepaid orders add $1 for shipping and handling.
I'm caught here. Hey, it wasn't too long ago that our next guest worked in a local grocery store selling tofu and the cheese. But now she drives a Porsche 928S, has $100,000 in her pocket. And it's all the result of being selected as the Playboy Playmate of the Year for 1983. Marianne Gravatt. Hiya.
Hi.
What is the secret? What do you eat? Why do you look that way?
I eat a lot. I don't
really?
Know.
You into health food and stuff?
Sort of.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't eat a lot of meat, but I'm not strictly a vegetarian. Once in a while, I do.
You really worked in a grocery store?
Yeah.
And then moved to being in Playboy?
Right. For 2 years. Over 2 years, I worked in a grocery store bagging groceries.
Wow. Where was that?
In Arcadia.
Oh.
That's where I grew up.
Yeah. Well, how do you, you know, everybody wants to know how you get discovered to be in Playboy.
I started with the Playboy modeling agency 2 years ago and have been modeling with them. And one of the secretaries submitted some of the pictures from my portfolio down to the magazine department. And that's how I got my original layout. That's how I started.
And that was as a Playmate of the Month.
Right, October of 82.
And then you moved, what, after they go through all 12 and then... Now, who picks it anyway? Is it the readers pick the Playmate of the Year?
There's a lot of things they go by, but the final decision is Hefner's decision.
Uh-huh. And you got the car and $100,000.
Right.
And what else? I mean, that's pretty good, you know.
That's
well, there
enough.
You are, there. You're on the cover here, right?
And for the year, I'll be out promoting, doing promotions
that?
For Playboy. Right
we're
now, they're having...
a little closer? It's worth it, really. I wouldn't kid you. You know, yeah, I got that magazine. So we're going to do what now?
Right now, the Playboy is having their 30th anniversary Playmate search. Next year will be their 30th anniversary.
30 years.
Yeah. And they'll be going to 30 cities. The photographer is looking for the 30th anniversary Playmate.
So they're going to go out and just search for one person for that honor. And she will get what?
She'll receive $30,000. And she'll do the modeling for the magazine and a video for the Playboy Channel TV.
Mm-hmm. Did you ever think you'd see yourself on the cover?
I was hoping to do a cover.
Yeah.
Before I thought of doing the layout, I wanted to do a cover. Now I've got one.
Yeah, a lot of times, because a lot of the ladies will do a cover, but they won't do any pictures
right.
on the inside. Yeah. Everybody asks you if you were nervous when you did the pictures.
Yes, at first I was. I worked with the same photographer on both layouts.
Yeah.
So we're pretty good friends now. The first few days was hard, but after that...
It gets to be a lot of work after a while.
Yes.
Yeah. So what will do for your career? Do you want to stay a model or move
yes.
into something else?
Continue modeling and possibly acting.
Maybe work the cash register back at the
no.
store?
No. I don't think I'll go back yeah. there.
You think it'll help you out a lot to be... the Playmate of the Year?
It already has. After I did the original layout, it helped my modeling a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure this one will, too.
If it hadn't been for the Playboy article, or the layout, where do you think you'd be today? Doing what?
I'd still be modeling.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But you said you got some things going on now for your career? Other than the modeling?
Acting.
Yeah. You got some things going on now?
Well, I haven't started going on interviews or anything, but I'm going to start taking some lessons. I've started, and I'm going to continue taking those. Then I'm going to go out on interviews and concentrate on it.
But how does it work? Are you an employee, then a Playboy for a whole year?
Or longer. As long as I can continue doing promotions for Playboy as long as I'm in demand. The 25th anniversary Playmate is Candy Loving, and she's still doing promotions after 5 years. So it's as long as you're in demand and you want to work, you can
yeah.
continue.
Have you ever met the original centerfold, Janet Pilgrim?
No.
Yeah, she's a nice lady.
I've met a lot of them.
Pictures have come a long way since 19... When was she in? 1954? Elizabeth, didn't you bring her by one time?
53.
And 54.
Mm.
She worked in the mailroom, wasn't it? Janet did.
She was in the subscription department.
Yeah, in the subscription department of Playboy. That's how they did it back then. And she was the first ever centerfold.
Centerfold.
And now Playboy has gotten into being on television also. Will we be involved in that at all? The Playboy
yes,
channel?
Yes, I already did that, a piece for the Playboy cable TV. They have videos now.
And what do you do on that?
Well, now every month when you do the girls do a layout, they will be doing a video, and it's sort of the same version of the magazine, only on film.
Oh, so there's a little bit of a difference to that.
Yeah. They're about 10 minutes long.
Yeah. Darn, I don't get the Playboy Channel in my house.
No. Neither do I.
You have a boyfriend.
Yes,
right?
I do.
Did he have any objections?
No.
Did he get jealous at all?
He did in the beginning. He's getting used to it now. He's pretty good about all of it.
What about when you start traveling?
I think he has fun when I'm gone. He says he misses me a lot, but I think it gives us both an opportunity to, you know, be away from each other for a while. It helps mm-hmm. the relationship.
Yeah. And he's from here also?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Well, we wish you a lot of luck with everything. And your, how do you like your car?
Oh, I love it.
Yeah. Yeah. What color is it?
Red.
Red. Look out.
Red.
For the red Porsche. Thank you very much, Mary Ann.
Thank you.
And we'll be seeing it on the cover in June. And our guest tomorrow, Mary Crosby, who's starring with Robert Urich in a feature film called Ice Pirates. All three of the Bottoms boys will be here. Benjamin, Joseph, and Timothy. They're now starring in Neil Simon's are playing our song. And Gwen Davis, author of the novel Romance. And we'll be seeing you then. Take care. And last, but certainly least, is this guy, Richard Simmons, who has his thing called Reach. He's worth $50 million. He wouldn't even send us the album. We just got a picture of that thing there. Anyway. But here in Hollywood, you don't have to just sit home and play records, and you don't have to go out to a health spa. You can actually have it come to you, because here, the health spa is on wheels. It's become America's obsession. Richard Simmons Anatomy Asylum. Holiday Health Spas. Jack LaLanne's European Health Spas. Jane Fonda's Workout. The Sports Connection. There's the endless stream of best-selling books. And, of course, the record albums. Richard Simmons says, reach. Jane Kennedy tells us to love our body. Mousercise from Disney. Linda Frattiani wants us to dance and exercise with the hits. The Jane Fonda Workout Record. Linda Frattiani Part 2. Olivia on Video. Now, just when you thought Americans had gotten the art of perspiring down to a safe science comes, now or never, a workout on wheels. The brainchild of Hans Boehringer, an Australian singer-composer turned kinesiologist, and actress Anne Turkell.
Well, now and ever is the name I used to work at Anne, because I want to get her in perfect condition. So one day she didn't want to work out, so I told her, listen, you either do it now or you never do it. That's how the name came about. And the truck itself was, when I was working on my book, Now and Ever Keto Fitness, I decided, you know, I was so pointed down on the book every day in intensive reading and research that I had no time of going to the gym. So I said, it would be great if a truck pulls up with all the equipment and I could work out.
Do you have a lot of customers for this event?
We have about 48 clients and 4 trucks.
And exactly what is on the truck?
We have free weights, fixed weights, muscle toxic testings, food toxic testings, and cardiovascular aerobics.
Why didn't you just open up a health spa somewhere?
Because we have a lot of celebrities. They do not want to be bothered going to a health spa because it's a driving problem, parking problem. So they feel it's much more easier if they just open the door, step out in the truck, and work out.
I think health spas are great for aerobics classes and that sort of thing. But I really wanted to learn about weight training. And the advantage of this is that you're sort of on a one-to-one program. And they specifically design a program for you. And at a health club, a lot of times you have to wait in line for machines and that sort of thing. And you don't really get the individual attention that you get with this. And it's a lot more convenient.
What is the cost of this program?
The cost is $50 an hour for 12 sessions. And the truck itself has equipment worth of $15,000. The whole car is worth about $35,000. So we have everything. We cover from dumbbells, as I said, all the way to electronic muscle stimulants. We have everything in the truck.
I asked a little bit earlier if they have any clients that hide out when the truck pulls up. Are there some mornings when you see this truck coming in the driveway and you just don't want to get in it?
No, Eli's fun, and I'm usually waiting for him.
Where else but in Hollywood?
In In Japan, the foot can split wood, but it can't split a watermelon. Introducing Ginsu 2, a brand new set of knives, like this Ginsu chef's knife. It's the first one in the world with a dual edge. This special Ginsu serration will cut through a branch and still remain razor sharp. This edge will dice onions so fast there isn't time to cry. Both edges together are like two knives in one. But wait, you also get this matching Ginsu cleaver. It can split a log and still handle your most delicate chopping. This oriental cleaver chops scallions, chops celery, and more. And look, it's specially designed to be a meat tenderizer. How's that for a clever cleaver? Well, we'll even give you this fantastic Ginsu slicing knife with a perpetual edge. The more you use it, the better it cuts. Look at this. You'll go through lettuce quicker than a rabbit. And did you ever slice ham this easily? What are three Ginsu?
Coming up next, the stars come out for People Now with Bill Tush. Right after, follow another exciting case with Perry Mason. Then it's a pregame look at the Atlanta Braves with the on-deck circle, followed by America's team in action against the Chicago Cubs, here on Superstation WTBS. From Hollywood, it's People Now with Bill Tush. Now, here's Bill.
Boy, are we getting swanky, huh? Hey, our guests today, Gloria Loring from The Days of Our Lives, Nikki and David Goldberg, authors of American Whole Foods Cuisine. The Maytag repairman himself, Jesse White, will take to the stage soon in Little Shop of Horrors. We're going to talk about that. Marianne Cravat, the 1983 Playboy Playmate of the Year, is here. But our first guest is on videotape. Because, well, I'll explain it to you. You know how we got everybody with health things going around, and of course the aerobics. Huh? We've got hundreds of albums. This is called Heavy Hands. Pump It Up is the name of this one. That's one. We've got this one, the aerobic dancing for the family by the ever-popular Judy Scott is one thing there. And here's another one. This is the classic aerobic woman. There she is. Also, on the back of this, it tells you she'll show you the natural way to healthier hair. And here's aerobics dance hits, complete with the hits of Cool and the Gang, Celebration Jungle Boogie, and Hollywood Swinging.
Two knives like this worth. Don't answer, because you also get a pair of paring knives. You'll always have one handy. Plus, you get this fruit and vegetable knife. It sections grapefruit and cuts cheese. It's so tough, it'll even cut a nail and still go through pineapple like this. Now how much would you pay? Well, you also get this utility knife that cuts tile, cuts eggs, and look what it does for pizza. All these knives come with the famous Ginsu handle. But hold on, you even get six world-famous Ginsu steak knives. They can cut through a tin can and still remain razor sharp. You get 13 fantastic Ginsus, plus our world-famous 50-year guarantee, all for the amazing low price of only $19.99. Here's how to order.
You get 13 fantastic Ginsu knives. Call toll-free 1-800-257-1234 or send $19.99 to Ginsu, Box 7500 Atlanta. That's Ginsu, Box 7500 Atlanta. You get all 13 genuine Ginsu knives, guaranteed in writing for 50 years. Order now.
Well, we're caught in the middle of a love triangle. It seems that our next guest, who plays Liz Courtney on Days of Our Lives, has shot her ex-lover's wife. And everybody wants to know if Marie, who is her ex-lover's wife's name, is going to pull through or possibly go to a soap opera heaven. Here is Gloria Loring. Gloria, of course, is Liz on Days of Our Lives. It does get complicated there, doesn't it?
It gets very bizarre. It gets to the point where you...